Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Yeah. I'm Ngo Michael Lyunga from Cameroon. I work with the Tropical Plant Exploration Group, TROPEC. I would first of all like to thank the BITC team for this opportunity to share my experience with my colleagues from different backgrounds. So I will first of all introduce you to my organization. As I said, the Tropical Plant Exploration Group was registered in 2010, and the headquarters is in Mondemba, a small town near a national park. What motivated us was to see how we can build capacity in botanical science, specifically taxonomy, and explore some of the areas that we think they are priority areas, and to also do fundraising for through environmental and biodiversity consultancy. Then, in addition, we carry out conservation and livelihood programs. And so the goals of TROPEC will be to champion and document plant research in high biodiversity priority areas, support and promote researchers with a common research goal, and train Cameroonians and other nationals participate in biodiversity conservation development activities and promote management of natural resources. And so we do operate in three different platforms. We have a research component, we have a consultancy arm, and we have another component that has to do with livelihood and conservation. And so I'm going to talk about our conservation and livelihood program, which is basically found in the Rumpihis area, specifically in the village of the Komebalwe, which is we are trying to promote tea cultivation using a forestry technique. And so if we situate our area of operation, this is Cameroon, and this is the zone in which we are working, the southwest region, and this is the Rumpihis Forest Reserve. This is a map of the Rumpihis. And this is what the vegetation looks like. And so the reserve is about 50,000 hectares. So the history of the tea in this community, the community decided to plant tea because tea is the only cash crop that they identify to do well in the area. And so some individuals brought tea from a nearby company that is doing tea production, and also another individual brought tea from Kenya so that they can use to improve on their livelihood. As I've explained, that is what happened before they started planting tea. So we went to this locality after realizing that tea can grow under shade, though many of the modern system do plant tea in open area. They plant tea in areas that there are no trees. So to them, they think that the crop can do well only in open area. So, but from our experience that we got from Sri Lanka, we realized that it is a plant that can grow as a shady plant. So we came to this community in the Komebalwe, talk with the farmers, mobilize them, and try to improve on their technique of tea production. So this is some of the pictures. These are some of the pictures that we had while there in the Komebalwe. So this is what a modern tea farm that most companies are promoting. This is what it looks like. But we are trying to shift this idea from this kind of production that does not favor the planting of trees. In short, it doesn't favor high biodiversity, because if you look, it's basically tea shrubs. And now we first of all assess what we have at the Komebalwe. This is what we have at the Komebalwe as tea farms. So what you see here is abandoned tea farms. These farms were actually abandoned because of the effort these people have been trying to cultivate tea since the 80s, but it hasn't been moving because they have been trying to do this at their own level. So nobody has really struggled to promote it as such. So we went to this community. This is a farm that one of the farmers is struggling to prepare. So according to the way the thing was being run, they were trying to market the tea in this manner. They packet the tea with plastic bag, then they take it to nearby market. So this is one of the tea farmers. Actually, the tea is of very high quality. So what you see here, it's the mini agro pastoral show that this individual came to display the tea puddle, and this medal on his chest is actually a prize that they got for the quality of the tea in the national level. And so when we got to the community, we had to explain to them our way of operation. So we came up with the idea that we are going to adopt a different method of production, which is actually forest garden tea being promoted by the analog forestry network. So we came up with the idea that we can, as a conservation organization, we can't be using plastic bags for packaging of tea. We brought up the idea of using papers. So we discussed with them. We actually come up with a marketing plan that we can attract the tea farmers towards our side, because we are a conservation organization. We don't have money to buy their tea, so we just have to build a marketing plan for them, so that once the tea gain market, we can now really support the idea of conservation in that community, especially as the community is just it's just close to the Rumpi Hill Forest Reserve. So this is what a tea farm in Sri Lanka looks like. You see the diversity. So we actually realized that this thing is possible to do it in the forest zone of the Rumpi Hills. So we are trying to mimic this kind of system that will encourage high diversity in the tree production system. So that is how we have been working. That is a little idea we have been trying to promote. And some of the constraints we have been having, because we are very nascent, we don't have money going to the area frequently, but at least we have been having some good returns. Most of the customers that have been purchasing our tea product as of now, they have been giving good remarks for the quality and the idea behind it. Thank you very much for your...